What is up, Squid Nation? Brian here from BigSquidRC, along with, as you can see, my guest star, probably the most favoritest Care Bear in the RC industry, Jeremy Griffin.
Brian wants something.
What? No.
Let's do it like real news anchors. Ready? Welcome to BigSquidRC. Here we're gonna talk news.
I can't do the news anchor thing. I'm sorry. I'm just horrible.
Kenny's not coming in today.
Right? Hold on. Breaking news.
Breaking news. Losi.
I was just thinking of your Reefs RC thing.
Oh.
So for those who haven't seen the Between Two Squids, Jeremy just rocks it out of the park. It's a comedy thing that, you know, we shoot once in a very great while. But the Reefs RC one was just posted, and it was hilarious. But, like, what made me think of it was the boop at the end. I was like, Jeremy could totally be the Care Bear of the RC industry. That'd be awesome.
I got my boops from RC every day. I mean,
not
too many people can say that, huh?
That was good. That was totally good.
Dude, it was really fun. But it was, like, we were supposed to do it Friday night. And then it got late. We ended up doing it. So we ended up doing it, like, I think Saturday night we did it. And it was – so, like, the first one, RC Every Day did it. You know, he edited it. He filmed it. I just, you know, sat there. This one was a little different. You know, I had a different camera guy. Luke Claxton, one of Reef's guys, was filming. So he did a really good job. But, yeah, it was fun, man.
It was good. And it was edited well. Like, I thought the cuts were very comedically brilliant, right? Like, there was a lot of just, you know, it was like the perfect pause.
Well, you know
You know, it was great.
The one part where I was like, oh, servo, you know, and I cut it like that. I had like six other ones that kept going. I was like,
oh, no,
I should do that.
Right. I was good with like three or four.
Oh, yeah. But it's fun. And it shows everyone that, you know, I mean, these companies, they have, you know, they can take jokes, you
right?
know.
Some of them.
Some of them. It's not all serious. And it was all in fun, you know.
Right. That was a good time.
And it just, I think it brings a lighter side to it.
Yeah.
And I have fun doing it. So
people in the comments are saying it was great. So
awesome. Thank you, guys.
So, yeah, if you haven't seen the Between Two Squids video, it's like one video ago behind this. So when the live show is done, and if you still need some more video content and Jeremy, you know, head over and pick out the Between Two Squids. It was great. And thanks very much to Reefs RC for hanging out and putting up with our craziness.
Yes.
No.
Yes. It was an awkward leading up to it. I wanted to, you know, ask him, but I wasn't sure, you know,
right?
If he'd be, you know, because Reefs kind of I've never seen him laugh that hard.
That was good. It was really good.
So it's definitely fun.
That was classic. Hello to everybody in the chat. Chat's going
what
crazy
is up,
already.
Everybody? I can't see the chat. So.
Yeah, so I got it's 11 Charlie RC is in there.
What's up, boys?
Kevin Gibbs.
Kevin.
Says Justin, the sandwich making camera king. I mean, was it Justin that was doing the filming?
That's JB the voice from
11
Charlie. Yeah, he was the crazy one running around with the GoPro on a stick while they were sending cars at him.
Oh, nice.
I was actually flipping through my photos trying to find like the 2 or 3 days after I got hit when it was all like purple. And
all right.
Aww. And I was going to send it to him and be like, we're going to be brothers soon.
Yeah, you will. Yeah, blood brothers.
Yeah, you just got to be going pretty fast to get on my level, bud.
JB the Voice is in-house. YSU Printing. Captain Flannel. I was thinking about you today, man. I was totally going to wear the flannel today, but I just went pro line at the last second. So
nice.
CSLRRC. Man, there's just so many people like in the chat right now. It's crazy.
Awesome, awesome.
I don't want to miss too many people. Zach is in the house. Dan. Let's see. We had JB. Orlando Diaz is in the house.
What's up, Orlando? How you guys doing?
Frankie Hamilton, Brian Taff, Kevin Gibbs. Holy cow. Tanner Runke, Stickies RC. Let's see. Who else have I not mentioned? We had a bunch of people early on. Like Voodoo Trucking. good seeing you. Like here. 2 minutes after I like, you know, posted up the, hey, it's coming soon. There were like people in the chat. And I'm like,
that's awesome.
We got an hour. I'm going to eat dinner. You guys are going to have to talk amongst yourselves.
You know? That's so cool, man. That's awesome.
Team Sergeant RC is in the house.
I know. I have a couple people that hit me up every Thursday asking if we're going to have a live show. So
Yeah. It's crazy now.
That's awesome. I'm not saying, you know, it's annoying or anything, but that's,
it's great.
That's so cool.
Except now we're committed.
I feel bad.
Now we're like, stuck, right?
Because there's some times where we don't know.
Right. Yeah. We've had some stuff where like not all of us can make it, or we couldn't get two of us. Right. And you guys don't want to see me by myself live.
You don't want to see me by myself either.
Ravika, Brian, Zach, holy cow. The comments just keep coming. Radioactive Scales in the house. So thank you guys all very much. Colin's in the house. I really appreciate you guys hanging out with us tonight.
We'll try
and keep up with the chat. It's usually easier with Doug or somebody here kind of reading the chat while I'm blabbing away. But thank you guys all very much for hanging out. 302's in the house. So let's see. What do we got going on? You want to talk news? You want to talk Losi Drag Car? Losi Drag Car would be fun.
Yeah, let's talk the drag car.
I got a bunch of like little things to like just kind of show. So let me get like one or two of these out of the way.
You're getting mail again and not telling me.
Yeah, right. So
malarkey.
So one thing quick that just showed up today is this new LiPo Smart, the new Smart 2 LiPo stuff. But this is cool because this is, I guess I could take it out of the box here.
Oh, is it the drag car one?
Yep. So 7.4 volt, but 100C pack. So like this is meant to take all of the power and throw it into that motor.
Yeah.
As fast as possible. So this will be cool. I'm actually looking forward to this and seeing how this does with the batteries. I think some of that driving might have been my battery, maybe a little bit flipping out.
It was
over the weekend.
It was kind of cold too.
It was freezing. Yeah. Well, it wasn't freezing, but it was 40.
But it was, yeah, it was in the, like, cars handle different in different temperatures.
Yeah. So, and the other cool thing about this is I don't need a converter plug anymore. So, new from the Spectrum guys, if you guys haven't seen, this now has the IC5 connector, which they didn't used to do on a 2-cell LiPo. It always used to be the IC3, the smaller one. Mm. So now for the drag car, they've got 100C packs with IC5s.
Cool.
So, very awesome. Totally going to put this thing to the test. Can't wait.
Because that's basically the pack that, like, when you're running, like, in competition, that's what you have to use, like, two cell. That's cool. Yep. That is
exactly
really cool.
So that's awesome. I can't wait. Yeah. Greg's in the house, speaking of drag racing.
What's up, Greg?
Greg Holman just popped in.
We should get, next week, we should just put him on here, too.
We could do Greg. Greg, yeah. If you got a setup, man, we can bring you in here.
All you need is a phone and headphones.
Yeah, right. That'd be sweet.
Brian looks like he's landing airplanes.
All right. Come on in. If you want to cruise by the tower one time around, that would be great. And then we can just land you in there. That'd be good.
I can't even. That was perfect, dude.
I was trying to think of a line from Airplane, but I couldn't think of one that the guys all in the tower.
You gotta be careful what you're saying.
You gotta be careful with the airplane references.
For sure.
Swolo like solo. Wow, that's a
dude. Some of these names are just amazing.
They're awesome. They're totally awesome.
They are amazing.
MT Rangers yelling clear for flyby. Heck yeah, man. That's awesome.
I've seen the coolest little like trailer for I think Top Gun 2, but it was all done in Lego.
That's
the
cool.
Best thing I've ever
That's a lot of work.
I love the Lego movies and stuff, and it was just so cool. So
right.
It has nothing to do with this, you know, check it out.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's talk a little bit about what we did last weekend, right?
Yeah,
so,
we played.
We had some fun. So this is, I'm driving the blue Losi, '69 Camaro drag car, which was a blast. And this is, Jeremy's team associated, DR10, right?
It was.
We had a blast. we just went out there and had a great time racing up and down, messing around. We got some filming in, we got a bunch of testing in, which was cool. It was like 45 degrees or so. It was too cold for us to really hook up on that pavement.
Yeah.
You know, it's just that pavement needs to be warmer. Those tires, no matter what we did, those tires were not warming up to.
And it was.
Especially on a non-treated. We weren't on a track or anything. This is literally just a parking lot. So.
And it was wet that morning.
Yep. You know? So, but, and dust and everything else. Yeah. We had salt all over.
Well, what's going to be even more fun is once that weather gets even warmer and the concrete and asphalt and everything's warmer, these cars are going to perform so much different and so much better. Even like that, we had a blast, man.
We had a total blast.
You know, it's been a while. We've been kind of snowed in for months.
Right. So I should have brought it down. Except I was afraid I was going to leak. I was going to leak shock oil all over. I haven't fixed it yet. So this weekend, so Jeremy and I are racing, and Greg was there too. All three of us were just running up and down. We need like a fourth person to film because there was just three of us going nuts. And we were having a great time, and we set up a bunch of cones. You know, we had like a start-finish line sort of thing. And towards the end, you know, we had done a bunch of races. And right at the end, Jeremy, you know, I had maybe bumped a couple things. We had both bumped and, you know, stuff a little bit. And one of the last races, Jeremy got out in front of me and kind of started drifting my lane. But the Losi has got more power than that Associated.
Yes.
So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to run over him. So instead of trying to muscle my way around, I just put it all in and just right over Jeremy and rolled it a couple times and then slid probably another 100 feet on my roof.
It was awesome.
It looked great. That roof is trashed right now. I mean, for all those people that are out there, you know, the shelf queen, you know, my dragster is the most amazing body on the planet. Mine is completely destroyed already. We had a great time. There were no apologies given during our racing. So it was fun.
It was, that's what we were there to do.
Exactly. So
it was cool is at one point when we were pretty much done getting the, you know, regular shots, like when we were kind of trying to get them close to each other, we couldn't do it.
No.
Like when we were actually kind of trying to get into each other, you know, kind of rub a little bit, these cars were just hooking up and going. And by the time, you know, we were past the line.
Right.
I got the drag racing bug.
And it was a blast.
Actually, my new body came in yesterday.
Oh, I can't wait.
That'd be awesome. Yeah, the J Concepts Grand National.
Cool. Very cool.
Yeah, I'm excited.
That's awesome. I've got to get a new body on order. I just can't decide. I love the 69 Camaro body. Like, I really do. Like, if that wasn't already on the car, that's probably the body I'm picking. So I'm probably going to get just another clear 69 Camaro and something else.
What's cool is like,
I gotta order another one.
Like the DR10, the orange body. I'll use that for testing and stuff like that.
Yeah. I've got a broken in test body right now.
Exactly. And then when you're ready for that race, that's when you put that pristine one on. But I think your blue one there, that would look really cool with like, say like a primer door. And you know what I mean? Like,
all right.
Oh yeah. Like when it is all destroyed and you're like, oh, I'm just throwing it in the garbage.
Right. We'll have to do some paint on the outside. Yeah.
Send it this way.
That'd be cool. We could do that. That'd be awesome. Someone's asking how much faster the Losi is than the DR10.
It was considerably faster.
Yeah.
But I know, like I said,
neither of us could really lay down all the power. You know, we were just spinning tires a lot and everything. But just some of our speed tests on 2S, I think the Camaro topped out at like 42, 43 miles an hour. But that was like an out of control. You know, I was still shaking and baking the whole time.
Yeah.
On 2S. I'd guess it'd probably hit 45 pretty easily if I had traction and it wasn't 40 degrees outside. Mm-hmm. And on 3S, we were probably in the mid to high 50 mile an hour range on the Losi.
Yeah.
And the DR10, we weren't there. We were probably, we were in like the 40s on 3S, maybe.
I'd say we were about 10 miles an hour, maybe a little more or a little less, slower than the low C.
Right. Yeah. But, it's just give or take 10 miles
an
hour.
And that's out of box stock. Now you had Greg, who had his geared. He's got a bigger tooth pinion or whatever, but his was like right up on you with it.
Yeah.
So, you know, but like out of the box stock, the low C's just a little bit quicker.
Right. Yeah. So, if anybody is looking to pick one or the other, and you want, so here's something else we talked about, and we're going to put this in the review and everything else, is if you are totally new to the drag race scene and you're new to fast cars, like if you're coming from the crawling world, the DR10, the Associated, is not a bad place to get started. You can upgrade, you can do everything. You're not going to be crazy out of control, you know, from the beginning. Now you can adjust the speed, you know, they even have on the back of the throttle for the low C, you know, I can switch it to 75% or 50% or something like that.
Right.
So you can work your way into it as well, but you've got crazy speeds. You know, I was doing 40 miles an hour when Jeremy cut me off, and I was like, oh no, you know, and I spin the tires at 40, you know, I break them loose and then run over him.
But
so
I'll say racing's not always the fastest.
Oh no, not at all.
Yeah,
not at all.
Your reaction time is pretty much key for drag racing,
especially on like a shorter track. We were kind of doing a little bit short. And like, if I was just a tad gone, now I got to catch up to you, and I'm kind of like throttling it so I don't break the tires loose.
Yeah.
I got to be able to, it's hard to catch up, you know, you only have 3 seconds to get down there. So, you know, or less.
Yeah. I was the King of the Streets.
King of the Streets. That was awesome.
Dude.
There were some sweet runs.
I kept checking like periodically throughout the day. Mm-hmm. And then it was like very late at the very end, you know, came out down to these two guys. One dude who's been doing it for 2 weeks, and another guy who ended up borrowing a car from his buddy.
Right.
And you know, the other one was the dude who had it for 2 weeks was like a low C or a team associated. I'm not sure. But the other guy had the DR10 basically.
Right.
And, dude, I was rooting for that, you know, the underdog, the DR10. And he ended up getting snaked out of it. But it was awesome, though.
It was good racing all day.
And to be able to go and watch it live all day, I can't for the life of me.
That was cool.
I can't
remember.
That
was great coverage. It was really great coverage.
I think it was like Drag Talk. I'm butchering it, but it was awesome.
Yeah, there's a few people that had, some different coverage, but it was great coverage from all the companies.
Yeah. It was a cool thing. Like,
and Tekin Racing, we'll talk about in the news. They had a really sweet like 4 or 5 minute video with a bunch of highlights and stuff. So that was pretty cool.
Losi did a really cool one too.
Yeah, they all did. That was cool stuff up there.
Like,
so.
We're going next year, Brian.
Oh yeah, absolutely. So while we're on the subject, I'm gonna switch back to big versions of us before we hit some news here for Jeremy. So this weekend we had the drag cars out, you know, and we were setting up cameras and everything, and we're putting out the cones for how far we're going to go. And right after I got my car ready, Jeremy was kind of coming up behind me, and I turned around with a speed gun. Jeremy never turned so white. He was just like, oh, like he was having a panic attack as soon as I handed him the speed. Like he was like, no. And Greg was like, give me that thing. And Greg ran down there.
There's
but
the
like,
I have not worn it since.
But Jeremy was like, I'm not touching that speed gun.
Nope.
No way. So just for Jeremy, I just ordered the Dynamite GPS.
Yes.
Because it's going to be a little more consistent. You know, we're out there with the speed guns, which are pretty accurate, but you got to get the line just right.
You have to be basically
to get it right.
In front of it.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's just, this is going to make life a lot easier and less scary for Jeremy. So, Dynamite passport GPS should be pretty sweet. So.
It's not scary for me anymore. I just say no.
Right? I guess if you're not going to do it, there's nothing to be scared about.
Yeah, someone else is trying to make me do
it. I think you were worried for Greg. You were like, Greg, maybe move over a little bit.
Yeah, Greg's got hops.
Right? He's got hops. He's quick. He can be quick.
That's why our kids were in the bed of the truck.
Yeah, the kids were elevated, 4 feet off the ground, way to the right, So, in other cool news, you know what box that is?
Yes.
So check this out. Oh, hold on. I got to open it here. So we just got from Max Amps.
That's my dibs.
Custom Big Squid RC 2S packs for the drag cars.
Yeah.
So like they're a little bit thicker so you can move them around weight wise or whatever. But we got 2S Big Squid packs from Max Amps. So thank you very much, Max Amps.
Yes.
Totally awesome. So, man, we got all sorts. We got 100C batteries from Horizon we got to put in. We got Max Amps packs we got to test. So.
And then I got this little guy from Helios.
Well, there you go. It's battery day on
the live show. For the SCX24, which is really neat because that's kind of a funny battery to have.
Yeah.
And that's cool. Way more power and everything. So I'm stoked about that. But those Max Amps, I mean, I just...
You're definitely a Max Amps fan.
So. I have 3 packs I've used basically all year. I went to Axial Fest and ran trails on one battery.
Right.
It's just you can't beat it, man.
That is definitely some good stuff.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna beat you now.
You ready to talk some news? Let's switch over to the news. There's some good news today, too. Let me switch us over here a little bit.
I haven't seen much of it.
Let's see. There we go. So Team Corrali has got a new brushless ESC. Looks like it's got some pretty good specs on it for 8th scale off-road stuff. Waterproof switch is nice. They've got some waterproofing. They've also got, I think they had a little video as well talking about it. So cool to see Team Corrali, releasing some extra stuff. It's a 6S.
Yeah, they've been in the news probably a couple times a month now.
Team Corrali is really stepping up their game. So then this week's Monster Truck Madness had some cool old footage from the Bigfoot era. Doug did a whole thing pretty much talking about like the sway bar stuff and why he really likes the sway bars in the front and the back on the LMT. And, he just had a whole article about it. And it was cool seeing an old throwback video from actual Bigfoot testing and stuff. So
God, I wish I had his knowledge. You know what I mean?
He is up there when it comes to the monster stuff for sure.
Anything like technical wise.
Yep. He knows what he's doing. this was cool. Arma announced 5th scale Creighton 8S roller. So for all the people that have been, picking up that giant Creighton and going nuts with it and loving it, but swapping out electronics or whatever, they've now got a roller version for you. So,
put those coffee can motors in them, boys. And send them.
Yep, exactly. That thing's huge. And $699 for the roller. So you're saving yourself a few $100 in electronics for sure. So speaking of Arma, we should also, we haven't done one of these in a while. We still got a bunch of Arma flannels to give away.
Arma flannel giveaway.
Exactly. Yes. So you got to stick around to the end of the show. Must be nice. Present to win, but. Yep. But we're going to be doing an Arma flannel giveaway. So,
yep.
Because Arma was in the news, you gotta do the flannel, right?
Of course.
Also, I just heard from Mark. I don't know if Mark's on or not. What was his handle? Daddy something. He was the guy who won the Arma vehicle we gave away a couple weeks ago.
Oh, yeah.
He wrote me an email, says it finally showed up. Mail's crazy nowadays.
It's horrible.
But he got it, and he was super appreciative and loves everything about it. So
sweet.
We'll be giving away another pre-bashed vehicle actually pretty soon. It is March, and for big fans of Big Squid RC, you guys know that means March Bashness is right around the corner. So we're going to be giving away, you know, whoever wins March Bashness, we usually try and give away one of those. We're going to give away some stuff here on the live channel for March Bashness. We'll be talking about, which I'd be pretty cool. We've not done this before. You know, we can put up like a little chart and we can kind of pick, you know, we can go through and see what, who we think's going to win March Bashness, which is never, it never is who we think it is.
No. You know? And it'll be nice because then people can kind of understand how March Bashness works.
Yep. Sure.
You know, there's so many people that are like, how did the, you know, the Trailfinder 2 beat the SCX 10-3? It's like, well, it doesn't work that way.
It's the craziness of the voters is what it is.
What people prefer. That's it.
Right.
You know, right. But it is cool.
Or not. We've had, you know, some people just go vote crazy just to try and tank another vehicle.
Yeah.
You know, because they don't want it to get any farther or something.
Yep.
They don't want it to beat their other vehicle that they like down the line.
It gets vicious.
It does. March Bashness is awesome.
Yeah, so. I usually turn off my messages.
Yeah, it's insane. Radioactive Scale RC says the Armor Flannel is awesome. Got his in the mail. So cool. Congratulations.
Good job.
Yeah. So moving on from Arma, we also had, this was cool. The Losi Ford Raptor with the Mint 400 Limited Edition. This livery is just great.
Whoa.
It really is good. Yeah. Congrats to Losi guys for getting that out there. It looks really good.
Yeah, it does.
So, I totally dig the checkered flag.
Oh,
the
400
logos on there is
everything
great.
About it.
The red wheel wells are awesome. So
whoever designed that should get a raise.
Yeah, right. The red tires, that's all good. Or red wheels, I should say. Yeah, that looks great. It's really good.
Red tires, that'd be pretty cool.
Red tires would be cool.
No.
some people do. There are some color tires.
Well, when they do burnouts, there's like
blue
colors,
right? I remember this was years ago. We were at Hobbytown, Orland, and somebody had brought in a car for repairs, and I was just hanging out in the back room talking to whoever is working on cars, because Hobbytown does a lot of repair stuff, or at least they did then, right? Because you're selling to a lot of newbies from Hobbytown. They've got a pretty good deal where you bring and drop off your car, and back then, you know, there was just a lot of tuning of motors. You know, it wasn't about, you know, just fixing an A-arm. It was like, I can't get this thing to stay running. And somebody had a monster truck they had brought in, and they spray painted the tires gold. And it was super interesting. Like, I was like, well, that's kind of, who would do that? But then the more you looked at it, they had like kind of a gold body, I think, and stuff, and like try to like hop a bunch of hop ups and just these crazy gold tires. I was like, I guess for bashers, whatever, man. If gold tires work for you, great, you know. So if you're just running on dirt, that gold's probably not coming off that soon.
I used to wonder why like racers always had these really bright and just weird 80s colors. Like, but then I realized like that's how they keep an eye on their car.
Yeah. You gotta be able to see that thing.
Yeah.
And tell what direction it is. That's the other half the reason why the front car half is usually different. Because when you're 200 feet away and you're this little pink and blue thing, you need to know that the pink goes forward. You know, that's pretty much it. It's tough out there.
Yeah.
All right. What else we got? Ah, this was cool. Reefs RC had this 6-piece hex and nut driver. I really like this a lot. I've got a couple of these where it's they're mostly just like Phillips head or hex heads or whatever. In all the different sizes, but I haven't had where it actually comes with the nut driver
and
stuff in there. So I like that a lot. That's cool.
I use the, you know, the Bauhaus one, but it doesn't have the nut drivers. And I've seen it. It's not some cheap China crap.
No, this one looks good.
It is. It's Robocop's finger, dude. That is awesome.
Yeah. So good job to Reef out there. Yeah. That's a sweet tool he's got going on. So this was cool. So, Trio aluminum servo mounts and steering linkage for the LMT. I wish Doug was here. We got a lot of LMT news today, and monster truck stuff. But this looks like it hooks up pretty sweet. Like the way this is mounted on here, you know, on these sort of arms and stuff is very cool. So, that was just neat to see another company out there doing, you know, cool hop ups.
I actually heard about that when I was at USCE.
Well, I was going to say, was any of this at USCE? Did you get to see one of these or anything?
No, they were telling me about it though.
Okay. So that's cool.
I believe it was the guys from Carry All RC were telling me about it.
Okay.
And I was like, oh, that's, you know, I don't even have an LMT. I was like, that sounds awesome.
It does. It looks good. It looks really good. Let's see what else we got. Hobby Plus. You were like just talking that. Small scale, 18 scale CR18 harvest ready to run.
Now, that's pretty good. I like 18. Like, even 124 is kind of a pain to work on. It's
small. 124 is too small.
And like 118th, I was like, that's a nice size. I was like, I like that body. That's a cool looking truck.
Yeah. Yeah. This looks really good. So, it'd be interesting. It is 129. It's a great
price.
That's
not bad. Yeah. For 118 too.
And there's a little video if you guys are looking for the small scale stuff. So I think it looks good. It comes, you know, with everything you need, apparently including a 600 milliamp LiPo. So you're set.
Nice. Yeah. There's a guy, on my friends list. His name's Corey. He lives out a little bit, I think, never eat soggy worms west of us. He's got this tiny, like, basically 124 scale top.
Oh, cool.
And he was like, yeah, come out and check it out. And I was like, oh, yeah. I was like, we got to go there and check that out because it is, like, he's got what I want.
We got to just bring all the small scale stuff, right?
Oh, it's so cool. He's got little bridges. Like, it's gorgeous. I'll send you pictures.
Yeah, definitely. That'd be cool. So yeah, that's cool. I like this blue color blue too.
It's like a teal, like green.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good. I don't know. Do all those lights work? Is it say on here?
I can't. Yeah, I like the tires and the wheels though.
It doesn't say if the lights work, but it's got a ton of lights. If all these work, you know, if your headlights and the top roof lights work for $129, that's pretty cool.
Sure.
So,
yeah.
Let's see. I don't look into that. Oh yeah, here's the famous Jeremy and Vin Diesel. if you guys have not seen this episode, it's awesome. Jeremy did a great job. Proof was awesome. So
yeah, there was only two things I had planned for that, and that was calling him Vin Diesel, and then the hat trick at the end.
Now, did you talk to him beforehand? Like, was there like a, hey, look, this is meant to be? You know,
well, yeah, I told him. I was like, dude, I was like. And I kind of kept warning him, like, as we got closer, like, I'm serious. I'm going to ask you stuff that you've probably never even asked before. I was like, right. It's not like a normal RC interview. It's right. Going to get weird. And he was all for it. Like, he
awesome. Awesome. You know, dude.
Great sport. Great sport.
The other thing where you guys are talking about RC Sparks, and he's like, do you even know his last name? And you're like, Sparks. Like, cool. I just about, you know, spit out whatever I was drinking. It was awesome.
What was crazy was that so morning, good. The next morning after we filmed that, I woke up to him saying, you know, RC Sparks, you know, Aaron saying he was retiring. I was like, whoa.
Oh, right.
I was like, how funny. We were literally just talking about him. So, you know, but good for him, man. He's had a killer run.
Oh, yeah.
And,
absolutely.
You know, it's he's spending time with his family, dude. That's awesome. Yep.
I don't want to make any predictions, but we'll see you next month.
Yeah.
Moving on.
For sure.
Yeah. Don't send the hate mail, but we'll see how that's going. We'll see how that does in 30 days. Let's see what else we got going on in the news. These RC four-wheel drive.
Those are cool.
JK internal beadlocks look pretty sweet for 1.9. So
I like those. Those would look good on the Jeep.
I like. Oh yeah, these are total Jeep. This is like you know, this is like Wrench's Jeep. You know,
yes.
Full scale, right? Those are good looking. So those are pretty neat. $109 for the pair. It looks like so.
Yep.
Yeah, they look good. What else we got? Oh, King of the Streets video. This was the Tekken. Video. So if you guys did not see King of the Streets coverage for some reason, it was everywhere on every channel over the weekend. The Tekken video is great. Like I said, I think Losi's got a video. I don't know if we linked it yet or not, but everybody's got some really good. Proline, I think, has got one.
Yeah.
So there was just some great footage shot by everybody out there. It looked cold, which was surprising. Like everybody else looks like they're a little chilly. there.
They're so. In Vegas. Yeah, I'm sorry. They're cold as we're out here in shorts and 40 degree weather.
Yeah, it was 45 or 50 yesterday. I was like, holy cow. Oh, dude, I had a jacket.
Had the kids out and everything. You know, it was awesome.
Yeah, it was. Finally, we got some good weather. Let's see. This was interesting. So Boom Racing's got this muscle winch, high torque, 36 kilogram servo winch. I've never thought about it this way. Like, you know, I've got a winch on my Traxxas. I've got a winch on, I don't know what else I had one on. But like, I've never thought of them being built like this with a servo. Like, are they always that and they just look different? Or is this something new? Like, so, they just cut out a servo case and made it a winch.
Yeah. So a lot of the more comp oriented guys have been doing servo winches for a couple for years, but they've been just I'm not.
Gonna but not like it. This, right?
No, no, no. So this is kind of a new design. I've also seen DSM come out with something like this, partnered with Reef too. But it's a sleeker design and I think it's a better way of, using a servo winch is that kind of setup.
Yeah. It was definitely interesting. It's got a little hook and everything on there. So that was cool. I just thought it was neat.
Oh yeah. It's slick.
Yeah, they've got all the specs and stuff on it. So if you're looking for, you know, servo winch, there you go. What else we got? Another team, Corrali, doing a little hydroplaning. This is old school times. So if you guys are looking for some video action, you can never get enough hydroplaning RC cars. So It's an amazing thing to see this little car that weighs, you know, no one's ever hydroplaning light stuff. You know, it's usually an 8-pound, 10-pound car or something like that. 6-7 pounds at least, like, well, doing 70 miles an hour through the water. So
like when you see the guys doing them with like the X-Max and stuff,
right?
Dude, I'd be so scared something would happen and next thing you know I'm going swimming.
I haven't talked to Craig the Crazy Ramp Builder. When he was like one of the first people doing hydroplaning years ago. Okay. And I remember he had lost a car like in like a pond. And they were just spending hours. They had boats out there and they were just trying to dive down. I don't know if it wasn't, you couldn't walk. It was too deep to like walk and keep your head up. So they like hold their breath and kind of go down and feel around and come back up. Like they lasted for like hours,
oh,
I think.
God.
Like it was insane. So, no. But that was a lesson learned. You know, after that, it's always styrofoam under the body or something. Cause if it goes down, it'll at least, you know, it'll come back up. So.
Right.
Yeah, it's crazy times. So it was cool to see them putting out a little hydroplane video. This body looks awesome. This Zoo Racing, I don't know how you pronounce that. Is it Bwo? Like, whoa, but with a B.
Bro.
Whoa.
Bro. You
know, right? Yeah, do your best Matrix, like, whoa, you know, or something. That's a pretty sweet looking body. I like the colors. I'm a big green fan, so. Thought that thing would look pretty slick. They had some nice shots. They did a good job. It's so low, you know, that thing's ready to go. It looks good. So, and we haven't really talked about those guys too much. So it was nice seeing them in the news. This was, I thought was interesting. So Ignite Design's got a nitro truck conversion kit for the TLR 22T. Mm. The first thing I thought was, Losi 22. I got a drag car that's a Losi 22. What if I install a nitro in my drag car?
No.
It's meant for the 22. Come on. This would be great.
I'll still take you on.
It'd be fun.
Now that there's max amps batteries in play,
right?
My mouth's going to write a bunch of checks it can't cash.
I'm going to sound way better pulling up the line. That's
this
all
is
I'm saying.
True. And then as soon as you hit the gas, you're just going to go prong.
Hot. Yep. A wrench out there tune in every time.
So. That's not fair. That's not fair.
No, wrench is allowed. Totally not. But that's the first thing I thought of when I saw this was like, oh man, I'm converting the drag car to a
that would be that would time. Be really cool though.
So I don't think I will, but no. But it was funny. This is a body looks amazing.
The whole truck looks pretty cool.
Right? So another company we don't really talk about. How do you want to pronounce that? Cows? Cowsy? Cows? If anybody knows, leave it in the comments. Phonetically, how I'm supposed to say that.
Sound it out. Cows.
Right?
RC Model Studios.
Right.
KRMS. There you go, guys. I hope
looks
you
cool.
Out.
So
it does.
You know, the 715 scale crawler. I'm assuming they mean 10th scale by that. We don't really say in here, but like it's got this crazy detailed engine.
I know.
You know, in the car. Like this whole thing just looks good. It's impressive. Yeah. So we got to see if we get our hands on one of these.
Yes. Go to that other shot, the next one.
This one?
Yes. Look so at that's like the frame, man.
That is like an actual frame for an actual truck.
That is so cool.
Crazy. So yes, super impressive.
So yeah. That is so neat.
Yeah, we definitely gotta see what we can do to get one of these. But that body looks so good. There's so many, like this has gotta be hard plastic. Nah. And there's so many little, like all the little lockdowns and everything on here. There's a million of them.
I think
and
that
nobody does picture. Nobody does a grill like that where it comes in. With the lights.
Yeah, it looks like an older Jeep.
Yeah.
Like a Jeep. All the Jeep guys are just freaking out right now because we're butchering
them. Yeah, they're like, what are you talking about, Jeep?
It's a PR72. Stupid.
Sean is saying it's $1,500.
Yeah, well.
That might be out of our budget.
I was about to say, we should start by pronouncing their name right and go
right?
from there.
Yeah.
$1,500, that's worth it.
Maybe.
I mean, if you're, you know what I mean? If you, I don't know. I'd have to see one in person.
Right? I'm going to have to drive one in person.
Yes.
Yeah, $1,500 is crazy, but it looks really good.
Right. Yeah. It better be a hard body for that. Wait, go to Isla. Like, it did look plastic. It looked clear.
I think this is a rendering.
Oh, yeah, that is. Okay. Yeah.
So.
No. Yeah, it probably is a hard body then.
It looks good.
Nice. It's so cool.
Yeah.
I still want it.
Got to call those guys, see if we get a discount or something.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Buy one, get three free. Then we could afford it.
Right? We'll give one away, you know? People.
Exactly. Right? I will totally give it away after we drive it for a couple of weeks.
I'm entering.
I will pry it out of Jeremy's hands and give it away. When Jeremy goes on vacation.
Right.
He's in California. to my announce, they've got an expert build version of their Superstorm Dragon. It's cool. It's always good seeing, you know, Tamiya, however you're, everybody. I get in so many arguments over that. I'm like, dude, I grew up saying Tamiya. It's just what it is. Nobody's like, it's Tamiya. And I'm like, I know it is probably, but I just, it's in my head. So
yeah, I call it Tamiya.
Yeah, I can't. But it's cool. It's cool to see it.
It's Kyosho that I usually mess. I always.
How do you mess up Kyosho?
I call it Kyosho. Kyosho.
Oh, Kyosho. It probably is Kyosho.
No, I just know it annoys people.
Nice. We're running out of news here. Jeremy's everybody scaling. Awesome, awesome video. If you guys haven't seen it, with a ton of cool pictures. Yes. And there's more coming.
Yep.
There's a bunch more videos in the pipe. So this one's got a bunch of pictures of all the trophy winners and stuff. So definitely check out that post.
Amazing builds.
Totally amazing builds.
Like that one in the picture, that silver one down there, that's all aluminum. That's real aluminum.
That's insane.
You know? Yeah. Crazy.
So thanks again for USTE for letting us partake in an amazing event.
For sure.
It's very cool. Another awesome body. Big design 720 GT12. Like, look at that thing. It makes me want RC car action, right? I love me a supercar.
Yeah.
That's on my goals for sometime in the future. I got to own a supercar, right?
Well, yeah.
So it looks cool. Their paint jobs are great. You know, they're doing a pretty good job. So hats off to them for making some sweet bodies. Looks pretty good. Rounding things up. Mia,
I like that.
The Ford Zaxspeed Turbo Capri GR5. Yeah, that looks good. That looks really good. So
I kind of want one.
Totally nice body on that thing. Everything about that car looks good. I don't know if you got another side shot, but like, the wheels look awesome.
Retro, man. That's awesome.
Right? Yeah, it's totally cool. So digging that thing. SoCal Monster Trucks. They've got a Warpath 3 Monster Truck chassis. I like the name Warpath. Like, that's just a cool name, right?
Yeah.
So they let us know that they've just announced their new chassis. Looks pretty good. You know, I've not driven it, so I don't know anything, you know, too much else about it, but I guess Doug has talked about them a little bit. Okay. It looks really cool. And I think it's got the pipes. Like, it comes with those pipes. It might be an extra, but it comes with the pipes.
So. Nice.
Yeah, that looks pretty sweet.
Nice.
Last up, we had how to print or how to paint 3D parts. And this was from Element RC. They did a nice little video for everybody who's, you know, a lot of people 3D printing parts right now. So
everybody's 3D printing.
Yeah. So there's some great tips in here on how to get that stuff painted. Looks very cool. Yeah, they did a good job.
So. Oh, yeah.
Let's see if I get back to us. There we are. Sweet. Hey, I think it's time to give our armor stuff away. I'm missing my pen. I can't write down the winning number.
All right, Jeremy.
Oh, no. I was just about to tell Jeremy he's on his own because I got to come up with a way to write down a winning number, and Jeremy's just gone. He kills his phone. That was hilarious. I can't wait to see the replay of that. So I can't let you guys go. I can't go get a pen yet at the moment, but when Jeremy comes back, we will. So let me talk about what we're going to give away. And then hopefully Jeremy shows back up. So we're giving away some Arma swag that we can. Hey,
my camera fell over.
Dude, everyone's laughing at you.
I only have so much distance from here to the camera, and like if I like it went.
It was hilarious, and you like kind of caught it, and because like we're on the camera side, all of a sudden we're like ceiling four, you know, like doubled into your hand, and then you were just gone. I was just about to say I'm throwing it over to you, Jeremy, because I got to go find a marker that I can write down the winning number on.
All right, cool.
So talk amongst yourself.
I can't even make it awkward. I made this the other day. No, yeah. Team Garage Hack. Carbon fiber chassis rails. I just put these on last night with Bauhaus, low center gravity, skids and whatnot. It's neat. I don't know if I can get into the 124 stuff, though. It's so tiny. Like, do they make smaller tires? I don't know. Do you? Because these are a little big for this body. I think it's cool, though. I don't know. I got a Ford cab, too. I think that's pretty neat. So we'll see. This is the Team Garage Hack stuff.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That article's coming up, I think, soon.
Video cool. and whatnot.
Awesome. All right, guys. So you guys sort of know how this works. Some of you do, some of you don't. So I will explain it. We are giving away a brand new Arma flannel shirt. This is like a $60 or $70 swag shirt. Orvis. It's got the tags, everything. We've got all sorts of sizes. We are limiting this to America winners, so it doesn't cost us $1,000. Dude, these things are so heavy. They cost me a fortune to mail right now. I got a ton of these to mail that we've been mailing out, and they're like, it's like $10 to mail this thing out.
Oh, yeah.
So, killing me over here. But we are giving away some Arma swag. You are also going to get sweet Big Squid RC stickers.
What?
As well as enamel pins. We still got a couple of enamel pins left, but we're almost out of the enamel pins, so... So if you're going to win, now's the time to start winning. So how this works is I go to random.org. I tell it to give me a number between 1 and 150, and it gives me a number. and whoever is the closest wins. So I'm writing down the number right now. Cap is back on the pen. You guys need to now put in the comments number between 1 and 150. Whoever gets the closest, that is our winner. So,
yep.
So good luck. We'll talk amongst ourselves. You've got a Reefs RC shirt on. Somebody was talking about your swag earlier.
I do. Yeah, I got a hoodie.
That's awesome.
And it was funny.
Is that from this USTE event?
Yeah. Yeah. So day one, it was cold. It was rainy. I wasn't prepared. And I went over there, and I think Greg got one.
Oh, yeah. You guys got poured on.
Yeah. Cool. And Greg got one from him. I walked over there. I was like, hey, buddy, you got a hoodie? And he's like, yeah, dude, like,
He's like, it's day one, and I'm out of hoodies already.
Everyone had a Reeves hoodie on Friday because we were freezing.
Right.
Because we weren't expecting it to downpour like it as much as it did.
Right.
And it is nosy.
Let me put a kibosh on this now. John Reefer Snyderson, and stop putting up all the numbers. You get one number. You get one guess.
Yeah, Jesus,
not 75 guesses. So that's for everybody else as well. You get one guess. You are eliminated if I catch you putting in more than one number. So Tony, CCXRC is in the house.
What's up, Tony?
He wants to know if you're wearing your high-tech hat with the Reefs RC. Like, what hat do you got on? You got it on backwards. Are you high-teching it? Oh, Traxxas today. Nice.
Well, my high-tech hat is in the house. I have a huge hat stash. I need to get rid of some.
I thought maybe Reefs like took it out and like destroyed it. Like threw it on the campfire, threw it in the mud, stepped on it a bunch of times. Like that'd have been awesome if there was like a picture later of like Reef just tried to destroy that thing or something.
No way. I'd be like, hey buddy.
Yeah, no, come on, wait. No. He's like, I gave you a sweatshirt. Shut up.
I like high tech. I like everything. That's the beauty of Big Squid, is we can like everything.
Heck yeah.
You know.
So it looks like all of our numbers are in. I don't see any new numbers popping up, so stop the presses. I'm looking through the comments right now to see who our winner might be, and I'm going to hold up the piece of paper. I think I saw somebody get pretty close up here.
I want to just take a guess, because I have no
idea. Okay, yeah, you get to guess.
I'm going to guess number 37.
37 is wrong.
Wow.
We have got... Oh, I got to keep going. We had 96.
That was close.
You were not close. SuperDrakesRC had 97.
Whoa.
I think he was the closest. This is actually the first week nobody guessed it exactly right.
Good for him.
Yeah, so SuperDrakes, you were the closest person. Congratulations. You know what to do. Send me an email, send it to Brian over at BigSquidRC.com, and give me your shirt size and your email address. And I'm going to repeat that again, because nobody gets this right. There's your shirt size and your snail mail address, so I can know where to ship it. Right now, everyone either sends me one or the other. They're like, hey, dude, I'm a large. Thanks. No. Where do I send this to? Or someone gives you the address. So like, hey, dude, thanks for the shirt. Send it here. Well, I need your size, man. Come on. So congratulations. Greg Holman's saying have a good night. So later, Greg. Thanks later, for hanging Greg. Out. Super Drakes, send me an email. Congratulations, buddy. For everybody else who hung out with us tonight, thank you a ton for hanging out. Thanks for listening to our crazy drag racing stories. Checking out some of the new products, Maxamp. Battery pack's going to be awesome. The new Spectrum 100C pack is going to be awesome. I can't wait. Mm-hmm. I also can't wait to test out the GPS and not make Jeremy cry with the radar gun.
So yeah.
Looking forward to that. Michael Talbot's asking when we're going to have Big Squid RC hats back in stock.
Oh, so yeah.
I'm trying to find a new place. Everybody likes the hats. Like, I've got the embroidered one here. These were from Lids, and they were crazy expensive. So I'm trying not to do lids again. I've done other companies before, but we just have not been happy with the quality. Like, I want good quality stuff if we're giving it away or selling it or whatever. So if you know a great custom hat place, let me know. But we're trying to find a place now because everyone's been asking us for hats. So we'll let you know, but I don't want to go through lids again because, like, honestly, nobody wants to pay me more than $20 or $25 for a hat. And they were costing me like 19 from lids, you know, in bulk. I had to buy like 100 at $19 each, you know, and I'm making a dollar, you know, if that, and I'm usually giving them away. So, it'd be great if we could find them for less than that in bulk. So, if anybody knows, hit me up, drop me an email or something. Congratulations again. Thanks again, everybody, for hanging out. Really appreciate it. Don't forget to hit that like button, hit subscribe, bash the bell, all that stuff. We really appreciate it. And like I said, we always pick random winners that leave comments below for Big Squid sticker packs. So definitely leave a comment below. Totally appreciate you guys hanging out. We're having great numbers. It's been another great week. A lot more fun. We got more drag racing to do. Can't wait to, we got a lot more testing to do. It's warming up. We're going to start hitting the track now that everybody's back from Vegas. They're going to school us out there, but you know, it'll be a good time. So
we'll be racing each other. Nothing.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just going to be, someone's going to step up and it's like, no, this is between me and Jeremy. this is our race. So, as always, thank you guys very much for watching. Seriously appreciate it. Got anything you need to say, Jeremy, before we're out of here?
Same stuff, man. Just keep sharing our and supporting, man.
We'll everybody's scaling tomorrow. Tomorrow.
It's round two of USDE with a video and pictures again.
Awesome.
And hopefully get the team garage hack out video. I hope it finished tonight, but you know, possibly Monday.
Nope, that'd be great.
Because Brian has to make music to it.
Yes, I gotta do some editing after Jeremy does his amazing editing. I get to do the easy stuff in the upload. So, all right, guys, thank you guys all very much for watching. Seriously appreciate it.
For sure.
We'll see you guys later. Bye.
Boom.